大家好，欢迎来到今天的蜜蜂财富盘前要闻。今天是2021年4月22日，所有数据更新至澳洲东部标准时间9点半。我是助理分析师 Nancy。今天的晨报内容包括市场扫描和盘前展望。首先，我们看到，美股市场，纳斯达克综合指数收于13,950.22点，上涨1.19%。道琼斯指数上涨0.93%，收于34,137.31点。下面看到外汇市场，澳元对美元价格为0.7752，昨日上涨0.0001。美元对人民币价格目前为6.4909，昨日下跌0.11%。澳元对人民币价格为5.0314，昨日上涨0.0001。看到大宗商品市场，黄金价格为1,793.82美元，昨日上涨0.98%；铁矿石价格为188美元，昨日上涨1.08%；布鲁特原油价格为66.57美元，昨日下跌0.72%。下面看到区块链商品市场。比特币，目前的价格为69,820.87澳元，24小时下跌4.97%，7日下跌13.98%。目前的总市值为1.304万亿澳元，总的成交金额为698亿澳元。以太坊的价格为3,051.72澳元，24小时上涨1.03%，7日下跌2.59%。目前的总市值为3,526亿澳元，一日成交金额为497亿澳元。USDT 价格为1.29澳元，24小时上涨0.02%，7日下跌0.24%，总市值为633亿澳元，总的成交金额为1,662亿澳元。下面看到今天的盘前要闻。首先，第一则消息来自 CNBC Yellen outlines a bold climate agenda calling for net zero emission by 2035. Under Biden, that approach has changed sharply to the point that some Republicans have said it is an overstep on Treasury's behalf. Australia pledged tech investment ahead of Biden's climate summit. The Morrison government has pledged another $565.8 million towards cleaner technologies on the eve of a virtual climate summit at which Australia is expected to come under pressure. US President Joe Biden is reportedly set to announce a more ambitious target to cut his country's emissions at least in half by 2030, after UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson pledged a 38% cut by 2034. Australia's current target is 26 to 28% below 2005 level by 2030. 下面一条来自 Bloomberg, Wall Street starts to see weakness emerge in Bitcoin charts. Bitcoin has yet to recover from its unexplained weekend swoon, and now the investing public is on edge about the notoriously volatile token's next move. They think its upward momentum is fading. 下面一条来自 Sydney Morning Herald, bound to bring further damage. China hits back as Australia torpedoes deal. The Australian government has torn up Victoria's controversial belt and road agreement with the China. 下面几条消息来自 Australia Financial Review。Megaport post more cash losses. Internet connectivity business Megaport has reported an operating cash loss of 4.9 million Australian dollar on sales of 20.2 million dollar for the quarter ending March 31, 2021.And Woodside quarter one revenue up 22%. Woodside said first quarter sales revenue rose 22% compared to a year ago due to higher realized price for all products. 下面关于EVN Evolution upgrades cost narrows production guidance.Evolution Mining has upgraded its cost guidance and narrows its production guidance for the 2021 financial year. Despite reporting a March quarter where cost rose, sales fell and realized price fell. OZ Minerals says gold copper production meeting guidance.OZ Minerals said that total copper production reached 26,842 tons in the quarter to the end of March, up from 20,231 tons a year ago. Total gold production reached 55,150 an ounce in the quarter, compared to 55,606 an ounce in the same quarter a year ago. The production sold for Santos. Santos says its acquisition helped March quarter total production lift 39% to 24.8 million barrels of oil equivalent versus the prior corresponding quarter.好，这是我们今天的信息来源，欢迎您的收看。